Let's work on Bloodsun. It's been a month or two since I last worked on the rules, and I decided to go from Alpha to Beta by taking out all the rules that I don't think are strictly necessary and put them in a separate document. For now, let's call them optional rulings. I like the approach that I'm writing rulings and not actual rules. They are not the law. Feel free to change anything about them at any point. No one should consider an RPG rulebook like its code of law. It's more like the pirate code. It's actually guidelines. So let's make a copy of this. By now I've pretty much given up getting a better title than Bloodsun. Let's call it the Beta. I think I'm feature complete. I'm only taking stuff out. Let's get started. Think the world doesn't need to be changed at all. It's all of this in here. I've started writing some Bloodsun short stories, and so far the universe has worked for me. Lots of opportunities for stories and drama, lots of potential there, lots of different possible scenarios. I've been thinking about races in Bloodsun. Are they more like different species, actually, or are they actual races? Can my elves and my dwarves have offspring? Or Thandorians and Aryans? Right now, I lean towards the latter, as with magic involved and all of the races having been brought to Thundor by the gods during the war. They may have been all some kind of proto-humanoid to begin with. Maybe they were all grown in some lab from the same base DNA. Who knows? It could be possible. So, for now, I'm staying with races. I will rename the Warlock to Sorcerer, because, or better yet, let's use the German word, because I don't like the word warlock. Let's call it a Zauberer. Random German word insertion here. This is all pretty good, I think. Okay, the classes, this is some actual meat. You don't actually need classes, you could just roll up your character stats, write like one sentence that describe the character and be done with it. And then the game master can decide on difficulty modifiers to your D20 rolls depending on your character description. Wizard will have an easier time learning new spells or knowing some arcane lore than warrior, but a trained warrior will have an easier time fighting in close combat or kicking in a door. I don't think I will boot classes out of the door right away. I might not need my skill system though. Got this elaborate skill system right now. Yeah, let's speed this up. Go to edit, find and replace. Warlock, replace with Zauberer. Replace all. Done. One change I made, I replaced the description of the Red Queen completely. She's no longer the ruler of the Fae Court, as that is a bit too fairy tale for my taste, so now she comes from a different dimension of blood and gore. I'm still using creatures of the wild, glamour and illusion, but it's much more weird and creepy in a way. I think fairies are weird and creepy if you focus on the darker aspects, but this is more unique. Came up with this when I was using the Red Queen as a great old one in a Call of Cthulhu campaign I ran. And works really well with the Blood Mage, I think. I don't think I really need the skill system, but if I take it out, I have to take it out of every class and make that completely optional. But I think there's balancing issue altogether. Maybe I can just say there are no skills. You're good at what your character description is, at what your class should be good at. But now I've integrated it so much into the classes. Each subclass gets their own skill list you can pick for, and each class gets their own skill list, and like the warrior and the scoundrel, their main drawing points are that they get a lot of skills. But I don't find that very elegant. It's not a huge skill system, but it's not a hugely complicated system. Yeah, let's throw it out. Right. Throw the whole skill system out for now. so I've removed them from every class. Let me copy all of the classes for that. So make it easier. You can just get it all out without having to worry about preserving it. You can rework the optional rulings later to make it into a more readable and coherent document. For now, copy all of this. All of the skill lists. Don't really need classes too, you could just have a descriptor. Like my character is a battle-hardened gladiator, and then let the GM make up all the rulings. Don't actually need all of these rules. Murkborg doesn't need them. But I guess it makes it a bit easier to get into it. And they kind of give a reference point what is setting appropriate. Good examples. I could always get rid of classes and just introduce a few archetypes, but that would just be like a character description, what they can do, what they can't do. I've played a lot of Fate recently, and Fate doesn't have character classes. It does have a skill list though, instead of attributes, so you don't have a massive skill list, but here I had attributes and skills, and you actually don't need both. It's only something to describe the stats of your character, and there's no reason to separate that in any way. Probably have to replace these skill lists with a short description of what the archetype is, of what it can do. as my Zauberer skill list. Here it is. I like virtues, vices, and scars. It's a good rule. Get some role playing in there. Can I get by with less abilities? Mulkborg has put intelligence, wisdom, and charisma into one stat thing they call the presence. I'll leave it in for now. Advantage and disadvantage is a good rule, leave that in. It's all not very complicated anyhow. Action points is a pretty good rule. Yeah, initiative is already too complicated for my past. Let's put it in here. To determine who goes first in the if it does not follow naturally. Let's say intuitively. Can't talk and write at the same time. Let's see, initiative, that's heading two, let's do heading three. Cinematic initiative. Cinematic initiative is if you use initiative like the camera in a movie that focuses on different scenes at a different time. So maybe one of the characters is having a sword duel with a bandit. You wouldn't just show one of them having one attack or the hero attacking the bandit, and then you go to the next hero showing what they do, and then show all of the villain's actions. No, we would show the hero fighting against that bandit for like 30 seconds and have a few good texts and reposts until something actually happens. Unless they are, you want to show that they are in a real stalemate, but usually they fight for a bit until their situation changes, until one of them gets the upper hand over the other. And then you might want to change the focus so someone can go help the hero, for example. Majin, your Google Docs does have such a great grammar, spelling, and style correction. Best I've used so far. Not perfect by any means, but best I've used so far. So imagine that you are the regisseur of a movie. But remember to let everyone have their spotlight. This must be feel. I like this more than classical initiative system. I mean, if you don't know what you're doing, it's not bad. But I find this more exciting. I already feel all of this actions is way too complicated. What you only need is you in your turn, you describe what you do and make your rolls to do it. Your GM what checks and rolls. So let's get rid of actions and all of this. It gives a good structure, but I think GN can just work out something like this. It's gives you some structure, but it also tends to limit you to what is in the rules. You tend to not come up with creative ways to act and solve situations and just focus on what there is in the rules. German surprise, German initiative. Yeah, it's not bad. Points, endurance and luck. So a GM can make something up, but there's a table for inspiration. That's not a bad ruling. It's just really badly formatted. Don't think I can fit all of this in here. Can I? Oops. Oops. Okay, can I make a second roll? Oh, I can probably insert column right. Insert column right. Then put the other stuff back in here. Almost worked. Almost. This down here. This up here. Still not quite enough. Not quite enough. Get this a bit slimmer. Now I should have enough. Yeah, now I have enough, don't I? Delete column. Shit. Delete row. No, that's not so bad. Delete row. No, that's better. Okay. Almost not a hard rule. This is already a ruling first aid. But that is something that might come up quite often. So let's keep this in. Yep, I don't think I actually need special damage in here. These vehicles already include some optional rules, I feel. Like fuel, how much it carries, how much it needs, only used if it's necessary. But if I take out fuel efficiency and so on out of here, would be hard to find. So, doesn't take up much space, I leave this in. Vehicle combat. No. I don't want to get rid of these examples. Or maybe I want to. Yeah, let's get rid. I got rid of all combat actions already. So let's take this out as well. Let's see what is left. This is already ruling, but I like this moving battlefield idea. Gives you a good idea of how to handle vehicle combat without it getting too complicated. Weight of equipment's already an optional ruling, but if I take it out of here, I have to do on a completely new equipment list. So this stays for now. This is already, the weapon list is already complicated. Let's take this out. I mean, there's great stuff in here. But really, you don't need something this complicated. Minimum strength, abilities you can use. Let's take this out for now. Yeah, I have to change this around a lot. Oh dear. Ranged weapons. Oh, this is complicated. Not bad rulings, but form of loading. Mechanical loader, muzzle loader, breech loader, magazine fed, belt fed. Oh, materials a weapon is made out of. Oof. Take all of this out for now. I can just put my ranged weapons back in here. Let's see, clubs, stones, swarring knife, slings. Yes. Bows. Okay, armor, styles of armor. I should put some price on here. Usually, my buttons. Let's see if that is actually what I've written. All my Range weapons certainly are more expensive. Let's write one here about weapon technology, just to give the GM a heads up. Thundor metals are already expensive. In my mind, Thundor has been strip mined during the war, and all of that metal has gone up into space and is now in some ship graveyard. Some vast fields of just space debris. So there's not much easy to reach metal ore left on Thundor. So metals are precious. Let's put this under armor, this in clothes, armor as well. Let's comma armor technology. Wood, bone, stone. Let's see, a machine gun for example, what cost? 10,000 coin. Entering is just a straight gear list, that's not complicated. I feel like chemicals, poisons and drugs are already a bit optional. There's not much rules involved in here. And I think they are fun, so I leave them in for now. This battle. There's a comma missing. I feel like spellcasting and corruption is already an optional rule. But might be important. But I think my corruption rules are optional. Yeah, modification of spells definitely optional. Use the free magic system, it's much more fun. Just a list of monsters. Yeah, I've taken out, well, not 31 pages, there are all the classes copied in here. I think I've taken out like 10 pages. Let's say, how many pages does the alpha have? I feel like I've been really productive when writing these rules. Right now I'm writing short stories and fictional text. It's harder for me to write than this kind of stuff, so I only write a page a day, maybe two. Well, this one, 81 pages. This one, 64. Taking out almost 20 pages. Well, let's update the table of content. And that is now also 3 pages shorter. Wow. Okay, I think I have to write a bit more about the classes. And I have to replace my skill system. But let's stop this video here for now. It's almost been an hour.